All right, guys, now that we're done with the, well, makeshift refurbishing, it came to us as a basket case.
Tony Stark was able to build this in a cave with a box of scraps.
And we basically put it all back together again, added some new parts, about $280 we put into the machine after spending $1,800 to purchase it. So not bad. That's actually a really good deal for one of these machines, let me tell you what. These things average about $4,000 to $5,000 used in decent condition. It's up and running, it's purring like a kitten, and let's get it down on the property and have some fun with it and take this thing for a test ride. We're just gonna play follow the leader for a minute. he flipped over our Polaris 400 going up this hill, so he's wanting to know if his Bigfoot will be able to climb over it. Climb up it. Oh yeah, too easy. That was too easy. Down. That's steep, and there's a lot of front weight in front of this. Oh, fuck yeah, dude. Yeah, the 6x6 can tackle that hill. Damn. To the next obstacle. Uh-oh. Oh. Yeah, he got stuck that time. I'm telling you, that's a brutal hill. There he goes. We actually get the Jeeps back through here on these trails as well, and JKU is the only one that doesn't fit right through these two trees. He has to go around, but other than that, all of the Jeeps have been able to make it through these trails. So I'm holding the camera level, and this, you can see the tilt of the terrain through here. Be doing a race test now. Of course, his is going to beat mine. The 8x8. So, these, the gears on these, you have reverse, neutral, low, and high. But the transmission itself is rated as a low gear, medium gear, or high gear transmission. So mine is a low gear transmission with the low and the high. His is a medium transmission with the low and the high. So he's probably going to be pushing close to 20, 22 miles an hour. I hit like 18 in my 8x8. So, but we're going to go ahead and race anyways, just for the shits and giggles. All right, you ready? Yeah. Say when. Say when. All right, ready? Go. Are you in high or low? Are you in high or low? Yeah, yeah, it's burning a little rich. I knew I'm gonna have to do a little tune up on that, but no big deal. All right. Yeah, you got me again. You know, it's funny. When I started getting into these Argos within 2 weeks of actually moving here to Arkansas, I bought my first 1998 Argo Bigfoot. It was OD green, though. And that machine was beat the fuck up. Somebody abused the crap out of that machine, the OD green one. And I did my first series of videos repairing and fixing that Argo, that 6x6. And after I got it fixed and everything else and was running perfectly, I ended up buying a 97 Argo Conquest in OD. Only this one's a 2000 and that one's a 2001. But yeah. I ended up then selling both of those and turned into a hobby to actually do frame out restorations on these machines because they're so damn simple to work on. But, you know, I enjoy their capabilities. These things. These things are awesome.
There once was a ship that put to sea. The name of the ship was a Bully of Tea. The winds blew up her bowed up down or below my bully boys blow.
Okay. But, yeah. And then I ended up with a 6x6 Vanguard. And then I ended up with two older 8x8s that I bought off a guy that I completely restored. And did bearing changes on and ended up selling these. Yeah, that's basically these two machines back together again in the same color, which is a kind of a harder to find yellow. But yeah, it's pretty awesome that he was able to find a yellow Bigfoot. That's pretty cool. We're gonna get these things in the water next. So the water trials will be coming soon. So stay tuned, guys. All right, thanks.